So this is Baruch Fleischman here, and I'm excited to start this new Shaar Hakavanos here, featuring the words of the Holy Rabbi, Rabbi Yitzchak Gloria Ashkenazi. This is the Tiva Kavanos and the Shaar Hakavanos, and we're learning Hanukkah. Let's come over here and just take a quick look at what's going on. This is the cover page of the first thing. It is the regular Tiv, written by Rabbi Rabinowitz. Let me give you some other things that we could see over here. Now he has over here some prayers that we could say at this at the beginning. Tefillah Kodem Halimud Rabbeinu Ha'ari HaKodesh. This is the Ari Zitzuko. This is his. Then Tefillah the Omra Chobakodem Limud the Kabbalah. So this is something that we say before Limud the Kabbalah. Maybe we could go over that sometime in the future. So here we are back again at Shaar Hakavanos, and now we're going to get ready and we're going to start. This is going to be a series that, even though that it doesn't seem, it seems like we just got through a bunch of holidays. And part of the inyan is that right now the sun is passing through this constellation for the next few days of Scorpio. It's called Mar Cheshvan. But in the Jewish calendar, it's not Mar Cheshvan anymore, it's Kislev. Kislev means at the end of Kislev that we're coming to Hanukkah. So it's time for us to start thinking about Hanukkah. We'll just get into the most easy parts, and then, of course, you know that learning the Rav is like taking a dive off the deep end, and so we're going to go. So here, this first one is called Drosh Rishon Be'inyan Hanukkah, Drosh Echad Be'inyan Hanukkah. Say the brachos. So we're going to the kavana that you have, you're supposed to have. Now, this is a these are the Shaar Hakavanos is a book of kavanos. Very difficult to understand what a kavana is, but he tells you what a kavana is. But the whole world is one giant, to me, I was thinking this is one giant kavana of the Ein Sof Baruch Hu. Because I see over here Rabbi Memran says in the book that we read, these little pieces that we see from this book. He's saying that your will, what it is you ultimately want, if you can find that place, that's you. And then there is a will of wills, of wills, of wills, and it goes deeper, what we're trying to accomplish. So here it says, Drasha Acher Be'inyan Hanukkah. Now we're talking about the Seder Hadlokas and Neiros, what are the order of lighting the candles, the Kavanas HaBracha. Now we're going to learn the Tiv. And the Tiv likes to help us out by repeating the words again and saying them in a different little format, plus bringing many exciting new ideas. So the Seder Hanukkah and Neiros Noheg Kodnusa. You want to know what the order of the brachos is? It's according to the text that you find in the Beis Yosef. Al Haturim, then the Beis Yosef, he says he calls it on the Turim, Vegam. B'sefer Shulchan Aruch. So all of these three things go together because the Turim was the original formation, then their Beis Yosef added on or changed it slightly, bring more poskim into it, and then finally, ultimately, with the Shulchan Aruch. Seder Hadlakas Ner Chanukah, the Tiv writes, Hoyin Noheg Rabbeinu Harizal, so we're reading the Minhag of the Ari. Kfi Shitas, the Beis Yosef, he followed the Beis Yosef. So now we go through it, and these are the halachos. On the first night, Yadle Kaner Shebitzad Yemino. So on the side, the right side of the menorah, that would be the first one that you would light. B'leil Rishon Shel Chanukah Yadle Kaner Shebitzad Yemino Shel Hamadlik. Number Gimel, Shehu Hayoser Rachok Min HaPesach Mikol Sheves Aneiros. The matik, excuse me, the tiv adds in, Hanukkah madlik bebais, al yad pesach beso bebifnim. So you're inside of your house. This is a situation where inside of your house, and you're supposed to light the lights to the right of the door. Yadle kaner ha yeminishu ha yosa rachok min the pesach. So therefore, if the menorah is on the right side, this would be the right side of the menorah, which would be the right of the right. So this would be the first away from all the rest of the lights. So what comes out from this, the tzarek shnei tanoim, you need two different conditions. Ha'echad sheyaskil v'neir shebetzad yemino. So the first one is that you should start with a light that's on your right side. V'hashniyah sheyihan ner harishon yoser rakok min depesach, and also that you should distance the first candle as far as possible from the door, mikol shaar haneros, and that it'll be further away than any other candles. Uvaleil sheni, then on the second night, yadlik ner hasheni lo. So then the light that is next to it, that will be lit. Shehu yoser samoch al pesach. This one is going to be closer to the door. Yoser menarishans. In other words, it'd be one candle closer. V'achakach yifne al yamim, and then you would go back to the right. V'yadlik haner harishon. And then you would light the first light. Now, how does this go? Did he say, he said that first you would light the second light, and then you would light the first light. Balel Hasheni, Yaskil Lahadlik Mehaner Hasheni. So you will go and you will start to light from the second candle. Shebetzad Yemino. This will be on the right side. Shehu Yoser Somoch El Pesach, which is closer to the Pesach, Min Haner Harishon, then from the first candle, Shehidlik Etmol, that you lit yesterday. And then after that, you should keep moving on like that. Let me get some. There we go. Ms. Small the Yamin. So you will go again from the left to the right. And then finally, you would light the first candle that you light, you lit yesterday. So all the rest of the nights, you'll do the same thing. That every new day you will light the candle that is closest to the door. And then you'll start moving towards the right. So that comes out like this. At the last night, Shuhu haner ha-yosir kora v'samoch el ha-pesach. He said, Nimsa shebeleil shmini, on the eighth night of Hanukkah. He says, maskil lahadlik min haner betzad smolo. You start with the candle that's on the left side. Shuhu ha-yosir kora v'el ha-pesach mekulam. This is really closer to the door than any other. Well, maskil bo, and you begin there. V'nifne tzad yemino, and then from that first one that you like, which is closer to the door, then you start moving to the right. Karov kodim. So whichever one is closer to the door, that will be the first one. Bebo maskil. V'nifne tzad yemino, you start moving towards the right. L'hadik kol harshmon neiros kesidrim. Hakarov karov kodim. So whatever is closest to the first light that you lit, which is the first more left hand side, then that one would be, whatever is closest to that, that will be the next in line. Let me see where we're holding now. One more. And he says, so therefore, that very first light that you lit, shehu betzad yamin hamadlik, which is on the right side of the lighter, nidlak achron belayla achrona, it will be the last one to be lit on that last night. So it comes out that the first light that you light on the first night, which is on the right side, shall hamadlik of the lighter, the person who's lighting, who nidlak achron b'leil shmini, it's the last one on the last day of Hanukkah to be lit. Okay, so now we're going to go into a little bit more, and we'll see how we could do this. We have little time, so I might just read the top, and then we'll come back, and the next time we have a shiur, we'll start getting into it, because, as you know, we have an easy start, but then it could really sort of like fall off the cliff in terms of its depth. V'amnam nivarev techila, so now we're going to explain first. Inyan kedushas ayam in ne'elo, what's going on? What is the kedusha, the nature of the kedusha these days? And then we'll start talking about the brachos that have to do with the candles, lighting the candles. So like we've explained, on Shabbos, Yom Tov, and the new moons, Yesh Bechem Tosefes Kedusha Al Mehachol, there's an additional, let's see, I'm losing this, I'm sorry. Let me read it again. Shnizbar shebeshavasos v'yomim v'yom tov. Then Shabbos and Yom Tov, v'rosh chadashim, and also new moons. Yesh b'chem tosefes kedusha al yemei hachol. They have more kedusha than the weekdays. Gam b'chanukah. So also we come in Hanukkah. The Hanukkah is a holiday that spans a week. So he said, b'purim. So these two, gam b'chanukah and purim. Yesh b'chem tosefes kedusha yosef yemei hachol. They have an additional amount of kedusha that is panemius and the revelation of godliness than you have in the weekday. Amnam ein madregasim shava the madregas of Shabbatis of Yomitov of Rosh Chodashim. So he said the nature of their kedusha cannot be compared to Shabbos Yom Tov of Rosh Chodesh, but nonetheless there's an additional amount of kedusha. V'neim heim nisba'ara kol echad b'mekomo, and now we're going to explain each one of them, or we will, each one that is a Shabbos, what's happening in Shabbos, what's happening Yom Tov, and what's Rosh Chodesh, but and Rosh Chodesh. But now we're going to talk about Hanukkah and Purim, and we'll see where that's going to go. And this is Baruch Fleischman here at the Tikkun Elevator Kolo. This is Shiur 1 in the Shiurim, the deep Shiurim that are going to come out here on the Inyan of Hanukkah. Thank you.